Hi, this is Charlie at My Messy Fingers. I'm going to be doing a build on new album that will measure 10 by 8.5 with a 1 7/8 inch spine. I think I pretty much have everything ready to go. First thing I want to do is get my hinge built for my album sides. This is going to come together like so, and I will have approximately a 1/4 inch gusset in between each of the outside panels. I use Tyvek for binding because the Tyvek is so resilient, it has minimal tear. It will allow my cardstock to glide over it instead of the cardstock gliding over the roughness of the chipboard. So this helps for me to preserve a lot of the edges from tearing on my album. So what I did was I cut a 2-inch piece of Tyvek about 8 inches, and I am going to, I scored it where there's a 1/4 inch gusset roughly down the middle. It's not always perfect because you're dealing in 1/8 of an inch, but I will have a gusset that will sit in between the pieces. And I'm going to add a extra bit of tape here. On the end, because I want my pieces to stick together quite well. All right, so I'm gonna quickly put this together. I'm gonna take this off. Come on. And then, excuse the tape, I'll get to this here in a little bit. But I'm going to line this. I'm going to kind of roughly give myself 1/4 of an inch here, top to bottom. And I'm going to run this along that tape line, which is on my first score line for my gusset. There are many different ways of putting an album together. This just happens to be my way. Okay, so I'm gonna take out this centerpiece. Now here's my spine, and I am going to drop this down a little bit so that I'm on one of my squares here. Make sure I'm gonna line this up. And then I'm gonna place this on the other score line, which follows the tape line that I have. I kind of had a space there. I'm thinking I'm missing a piece. All right, let's put another row of tape on here. And I'm going to take out the middle. I'm going to turn this back over, and then I'm going to give myself roughly 1/4 of an inch top to bottom, follow my score line. It's not really super critical where the Tyvek lies. You can actually go from end to end if you wish. Let me get this back over here. So forget to take this off. All that. Now I'm bringing in the other piece. It's going to rest right on that score line. I'm going to match my pieces up and the height. Oh, too much. I apologize. I do have to do some surgical work here. I got it too high and it's not gonna work well when we put the album together. So let me behave myself and line this up. And then put this back down. There we go, much, much better. On. All right, so it's okay. I gotta have tape on both sides. I just noticed that I taped down, but it's more of a reminder for me. It'll work. You'll see. Okay, I cut these pieces. These stayed at 12 inches. My 65-pound weight that I'm going to wrap is at 9.5. I'm going to have a half an inch roughly all the way around. But I am going to seam this together with a piece of 1/4-inch tape. And I want, when I put this together, I want that seam as close to the middle as I can get it. So here's my 1/4-inch seam. I don't want my seams in my gussets. I don't want my seams on the edges. There's a point of vulnerability there. So I like to have the seam down the center where I can secure it a lot better. And it belongs there. So you're not looking at seams in your work out here. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to wrap this with 1/2-inch tape. This is what's going to get folded over the edges. These end up becoming long strips of tape, but it keeps me from having to cut and trim a whole bunch. So if you want to put in shorter pieces, it's your album, by all means, go for it. Now, this is where a part where this on this side comes in handy, and unfortunately, this will get used later on in the album, and I'll have to put some on this side. But I'm going to tape this down. I'm going to use a 3/8-inch tape here along the gussets, and I want them to be sharp, so I'm going to fold this and then lay my tape. And then I'm going to fold this. And I'm going to lay my tape. And then I'm going to repeat the process for the other side. I'm going to push back on this so I get the tape where I want it. Now down the gusset, I am going to run a strip of tape down the middle. Oh, that tore awkward. Doesn't matter. And then for the rest of this, I'm going to tape, we use quarter inch tape. I'm going to start down here at this end. And I'm going to come in the middle. And then I'm going to come in the middle again. I want to make sure that my cardstock is down against the chipboard and that it doesn't get that floaty appearance or that popping up appearance. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of do a dry fit here. I'm going to come right up to the half inch line on this end of this tape and see how I favor down here. I'm just going to scooch it just a little bit. I want to make sure that I have the balance correct all the way around. I'm going to firmly hold down on my left side and I'm going to take the tape out of the middle. Now when I pull on this, I'm going to give a gentle tug, lay this back down, and then push. And the reason I give a gentle tug is I don't want this happening. I don't want this happening. I don't want this happening. I want this to stay open. Now we're going to get in here. And we're going to take out the tape. And once again, I'm going to gently pull and press. And now I'm going to do this other side. And I please excuse me for the twisting and the angling of my album, but it's how I've got to get in here. Okay, and then a nice gentle pull. Okay, so my spine is in place. And now I will start to take the tape off the reverse side. The first one being the important one. Again, I'm going to do a firm little pull, make sure this stays separated, and then press down, and then I can finish taking the rest of the tape off. Now, if you want to take all the tape off, that's fine. Just keep in mind that you need to pull out on the chipboard panel to keep the gusset at the quarter inch. In fact, I'll show you. So if I just take all these off, it's pretty easy to do actually. I just get, okay, gentle tug, lay it down. Now we're going to burnish. And now your album is together and you've got your gussets. Now we're going to cut and create our corners so that we can finish our wrap. This tool that I'm using, in case you are watching for the first time, get some stuff in there, is a 2-in-1 trim tool. I'm not sure what the one is or what the two is, but I use it to create the angles on my albums. It's from colorweightarts.com. It's called a 2-in-1. Fairly weighted, so it's, excuse me, stays down on your workplace quite well. All right, let's get going here. and I get corners that are not necessarily perfect, but you don't notice it when the album finally comes together. And then I'm gonna push and smush that down in there. See, I get an acceptable corner, especially when I'm going to come up here and cover the inside panels when I go to finish my album build. And the same thing, I'm going to push and turn. I'm going to pick this out of here right now so it's a little bit easier to get a hold of here in a minute. Have to bend this back a little bit because the tape is right up underneath the chipboard. Get that creased up on there really good and then start in the middle. Just realized those were on there, so I'm going to pull them back here real quick before I get this fully committed, because I will need tape there. I just unfortunately flipped to the wrong side. Okay, now the next thing I'm going to do is first off trim these. Is I'm going to take my bone folding tool here and I'm going to gently press the cardstock up against the side panels, the edges of the chipboard. And the reason I want to do that is so that when this turns, those turn to the inside and that they don't bunch and buckle on the outside. I'm going to repeat here. See how it's starting to buckle up? So, and I'll bring this up a little bit closer. So if I'm folding this, this side is folding inward, this one's folding out. So by my doing this, and the fact that there's tape on there, it's committing it to staying on the inside. So then when I go to fold my album, I have nice clean corners. So the last thing I need to do is I cut this is 7 or 8.5 inches. I hope I cut this right. 8.5 inches. And I cut it 1/8 of an inch shorter. because I don't want the edge of this all the way up here, just slightly down. It's 6 inches across. Let's just confirm this. So it's about 8 3/8 by 6 inches. I have taped the entire piece, but I'm only going to remove one for the moment. Woo! That wanted to stay with my hand. Now what I'm going to do, and I'll have to lift this one completely off, is I'm going to balance this evenly between the two panels. I'm going to come in just a fraction of an inch down. It doesn't have to be perfect from edge to edge, but I do want to make sure that I've got my gussets covered. So I will now take this off. And I'll take that off. And now I'm going to repeat the same process that I did when I made the gusset creases, but this time I'm going to go the full length. This is buckling. Did I leave a piece of tape in there? I did. What am I going to do here? Well, I don't have a choice. This is frustrating. I left a strip of tape in there, and that means it's not going to stay down, and I'm going to have a buckle. So, excuse me while I perform yet again a surgery. Just got to get it far enough so I can get to... There it is. All right. Let's see if we can fix this. Okay, so this will stick once it dries, but I'm going to go back to creasing on this edge of this chipboard. And again, by doing so, it will allow the paper to fold to the inside of the gusset and fill it rather than it popping out of the gusset. Now, I'm not using... I'm using rounded edges, so I usually don't get a tear, but if you happen to get a tear, just take some glue, your favorite glue, and glue along the tear, and it should be just fine. So then again, you can see how this is folding in. This is still wet, so excuse it. Let's look at this end, it's a little bit drier. Because the undo hasn't completely dried yet. But you can see you've got some nice gussets here. So everything is inside the gusset. And you don't have any bunching up. You're not going to be putting anything else the way I make my albums. There will be nothing else going into the gussets except for what you've already pressed inside there. All right. So that is your 8.5 by 10 album build with a 1 7/8 inch spine. Thank you for watching.